Hey guys, it's Kaylee, welcome back to my channel. I'm coming to you today from a slightly different angle because I am going to chat you through all of the books I plan to read in June, so we are going to build my TBR together. So I'm just going to jump straight into the books because I'm being very ambitious and I have been reading a lot more than I usually do, so all that means is I'm buying more books and I just want to put them all in my TBR and read them all at once. So that's what we're going to do today. So the first one that I have to speak about is not going to be on the TBR itself because it is an ebook. I have been sent an e-arc of Breaking and Mending by Joanna Cannon via NetGalley. This book was already released in hardcover and on Kindle in September of last year, but I am reading this book in preparation for the paperback release, which is on the 2nd of July. I've read Joanna Cannon's two previous novels, The Trouble with Goats and Sheep, Three Things About Elsie, and I enjoyed both of those. The Trouble with Goats and Sheep is one of my favourite books. So I'm really excited to jump into this one. This is pretty much what it says on the tin. The subtitle of this book is A Doctor's Story of Burnout and Recovery. So it is basically just Joanna Cannon telling her story as a doctor working in the psychiatric ward and basically explaining the challenges of that job. So that is the first book that I am hoping to get to this month. The second two books I have up on the cart already, so these are two carryovers from this month, the month of May. I have actually got about five books that I haven't yet finished from my May TBR, but with a few days left of the month I'm hoping to get to a few more, and these are the two that I think I probably won't get to. So these two are, first of all, The Mars Room by Rachel Kushner. This one was actually Danny's pick for me. I always get Danny to pick me a book off of my shelf to read, pretty much just based on their spines on the bookshelf. And he picked this one for me last month and I've not read it, so he's a bit annoyed at me. But I will hopefully get to this one at the beginning of June. And then the other book that I have carrying over is Instructions for a Heatwave by Maggie O'Farrell. This one was actually on my Goodreads Want to Read project for May, which I don't think I've spoken about this project yet on my channel. Pretty much every month I look back at my Goodreads Want to Read shelf and I look at the books I added for the corresponding month 2 years ago. So this book I added to my Goodreads Want to Read shelf in May 2018. And because I owned that book on my shelf, I had to add it to my TBR. I basically go through all of the books and it's a good way of culling some books that I added to my want to read shelf that actually I don't have an interest in anymore. And then it highlights a handful of books that I then now own and are on my shelf and encourages me to pick them up. So this one, as well as one other Maggie O'Farrell book, I added in May 2018. So I'm prioritising one over the other and I'm hoping to get to the other one before the end of May, and I will get to this one in June. So speaking of my want to read project, I have done the same thing for June, and there are two books on my want to read shelf that I added in June 2018 that I have on my shelf. Funnily enough, both of these books I have started in the past and have put down for whatever reason. So the first book is a bit of an intimidating one, and that is The Iliad by Homer. So I started to read this, gosh, I don't even know when, and I got about a quarter, maybe a third of the way through. I'm unsure why I put it down. I was enjoying it, but it maybe just wasn't engaging me at the time. I think now that I have a bit more of a knowledge of the story, because I have read A Thousand Ships recently by Natalie Haynes, which is retelling the story of the Battle of Troy. So I think now that I have a better knowledge, it will be easier for me to read this one. So I might break this up. I know I did that back when I was starting to read it before. I kind of broke it up into sections, and I might read this over the course of the month and break it up a little bit. So I am excited to get to this one. And the other book that was on my Goodreads Want to Read shelf from June 2018 is The Overstory by Richard Powers. So I picked up this book and was reading it when I moved into this house, which is pretty much a year ago. We moved in at the beginning of May last year. And I mean, anybody that's moved house will know that that is probably the worst time to have focus on anything. So I got this far. I'm probably about 80% of the way through the book. So I really don't have long left to go at all, but I think I will reread this one from the beginning and just start it again. This one kind of has a lot of mixed opinions about it. A lot of people really, really love it, and then I think a lot of people that I have watched on BookTube actually DNF'd it and didn't enjoy it so much. And obviously I myself did put it down, but I think because of the things that were going on in my life, you know, I don't think it speaks for the book. I think it just speaks about the time that I was in. So I'm super excited to get back to this one. I really was loving the book when I was reading it. I think I remember enjoying the beginning more than the middle, and maybe that's why my interest slipped a little bit, but excited to get back to this one, and I think this is the perfect time of year to read a book about trees. So the next little stack of books that I have in front of me are all parts of series that I am in the middle of. So I'm really trying my hardest to, every time I'm in the middle of a series, read a book from that series each month, because if I let a significant amount of time pass in between books, I just have the worst memory and I forget everything. So the first one that I have is no surprise. I'm going to reread Mockingjay. I read Catching Fire last month. Really, really enjoyed my reread. And I haven't bought myself a copy of The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes yet. But once I read this one, I will get my hands on that and probably read that very soon. The next one that I have is the fifth book in the Vampire Academy series, Spiritbound by Rochelle Mead. I literally just the other day finished the fourth book in this series, Blood Promise, and really enjoyed it. I think that one was actually my favourite in the series so far, so I'm excited to just jump straight into the next one, and I feel like I'm really close to the end of this series now. I never actually read these back when I was a teenager. I've had them for years, but I never did read them. So yeah, this is my first experience with the series, and yeah, it's a fun, exciting, romantic, action-packed series with surprisingly a lot of character development and character growth. So yeah, excited to jump into this one soon. And then lastly, for my pile of sequels, I have The Winter of the Witch by Catherine Arden. So this is the third book in the Winternight trilogy, and I read The Girl in the Tower a couple of months ago now and absolutely loved it. I gave that book 5 stars. It was amazing. So I'm really excited to see how the trilogy ends, and I've heard from a lot of people that this is a fantastic conclusion to the trilogy, so I am really, really excited to pick this one up. So the next two books that I have are actually part of a project that I am doing. I love a project. So you can kind of see the rest of the books just here on my second shelf of my book cart. But I posted a video a few days ago about the books that have been on my TBR shelf the longest. So I picked out 5 books that I have owned for the longest time, several years. And so I've picked 2 books that I am hoping to get to in June. So the first of those is The Song of Achilles by Madeline Miller. So this is another retelling of the Trojan War, so I feel like that is quite apt considering I'm reading the Iliad this month as well. A lot of people's favourite book, very highly rated, and yeah, I'm excited to get to this. I'm also, literally, I'm doing about 50 million projects, trying to read all the previous winners of the Women's Prize for Fiction, and this won the prize I think in 2012, so yeah. This ticks a lot of boxes for me, and also I just really want to read it, so that's why it's on this list. And then the other book from that project that I'm hoping to get to this month is The Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. This one, I mean, I said it in my last video, but it's just been recommended to me loads. All the things I like in books, people say is in this one, so excited to get to it. I think there's obviously some sort of magical fantasy element to the book, and I've not really read a lot of fantasy recently, so yeah, super excited to try this one out. And again, it's been on my shelf for like 8 years, so it's about time. So then I would like to get to some of the new books that I've picked up. I did post a book haul not that long ago. I've been buying a lot of books on Kindle, and I have got a few new physical books as well, and so I would like to get to these books sooner rather than later, so they don't sit around on my shelves for years like some of the other ones. So on Kindle, the ones that I would like to get to this month are Miracle Creek by Angie Kim. This one, when I posted it in my book haul, a lot of people said they'd either read and really enjoyed or that they were interested in, so I'd really like to get to this one soon and see what I think about it. This is like a legal courtroom thriller, I think. Sounds really exciting. And then the other one that I would like to get to is The Duchess Deal by Tessa Dare. So I bought the whole series of books. I think the series is called Girl Meets Duke. I bought all of these because I started watching booktubers talking about romance and I got really excited and just bought them. And I've also bought a load of 99p and free romance books on Kindle as well. So I feel like I should actually read some of them. So I'm going to read The Duchess Deal this month. I'm going to get to that one, and who knows, if I absolutely love it, I might just binge the rest of the series, but I will definitely get to the first one in that series this month. And then I have three physical books that I have bought recently. I think I've hauled all of these in my last video, apart from maybe this first one. So I have bought a copy of Spring by Ali Smith. I've read her previous two books in this seasonal quartet series, and I enjoyed Autumn somewhat, but Winter I really, really loved. So I'm excited to move on with Spring, and I definitely wanted to read this while we were in Spring. So that is my reasoning for that one. And then the last fiction book on my TBR is The Murder at the Vicarage by Agatha Christie. So I did talk about this in my last haul video. I've never read Agatha Christie before, which is crazy to me. And I really want to get into cozy mystery series. And I feel like, I mean, Agatha Christie is the queen of that, isn't she? So this is the first book in the Miss Marple series. And I'm just really excited to get to it. I feel like I could probably read this one in a day, and it'll just be a really nice palate cleanser in between maybe some longer books. So yeah. Excited to get to this one. And then finally, we're at the end of the list now. I have a non-fiction pick. I do like to read non-fiction here and there. I read a couple in May, but I noticed when I was building this TBR that I don't have any on for this month. So I am hoping to get to On Chapel Sands, My Mother and Other Missing Persons by Laura Cumming. Again, I spoke about this in my book haul, so I will link that for you, but this is Laura Cumming's memoir where she talks about herself, but mainly her mother's childhood and when her mother went missing when she was a child and was gone for 5 days and then appeared again in a nearby village. So I think there's kind of elements of memoir and elements of true crime, which just sounds right up my alley. So I'm excited to pick this one up. So that is it. I feel like I have built this TBR just exactly to fit the book cart, which just really pleases me quite a lot. If you've read any of these books that I've mentioned, please let me know what you thought of them down in the comments. I'd love to know. And please let me know what you guys are reading in June. Do you have any plans? I'd love to start a conversation. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!